If you just sit there eating mint after mint after mint and say, I've eaten 12 mints today, you won't see nearly as much benefit. This is why xylitol hasn't always been fully appreciated. If immediately you have xylitol, the minerals are replenished and your teeth will stay young, strong, healthy. They'll be as white as nature intended your teeth to be. The beauty of xylitol. Doesn't really go together, does it? Because we don't like the word xylitol. It sounds so artificial. It sounds so peculiar and something that in America, certainly people haven't heard much about until recently. The thing is, it's sugar from the birch tree. And the birch tree is such a beautiful tree. This is a twig or a branch from a birch tree, a silver birch tree, in fact. And birch trees are unique in their fact that they're probably the oldest tree in the world. They are thought to have been around in the time of dinosaurs. And they grow really close in up to the tundra, up to the areas, the cold areas in the world. So a lot of these countries that are cold countries are familiar with the birch tree. In Russia, in Siberia, in northern Turkey, China, all these countries are familiar with the wonders of the birch tree. There are lots and lots of stories, cultural stories in Scandinavia about what they call the queen of the forest, the birch tree, of the beauty and the medicinal things that they have not only extracted from the wood of birch trees, but also the incredible resource. It was how the indigenous people in America made canoes, how they used the tar from boiling the sap of birch trees to actually make things waterproof. So the birch tree and its beauty was known and respected all around the globe in the Northern Hemisphere where it grows. So when I arrived in America, I actually took a horse ride through the forests around upstate New York, and the guide on this trip, when we got to the birch tree part of the forest, I asked him, what do you know about birch trees? Because I had had this interest in xylitol, knew it came from birch trees, and I was really surprised at the knowledge this guide had. He was one of the member of an indigenous tribe from upstate New York, and he was well aware that his ancestors used to cut the equivalent of little matchsticks from birch trees and use them to clean their teeth. He knew there was something in the wood that helped to keep teeth healthy. He told me how they would give little birch chew sticks to children as their teeth were coming into the mouth so they could chew on them, and it had something that made their mouths healthy. Now, of course, back then, nobody knew the biology of the mouth, nobody had microscopes, nobody knew any more that when they did these things, good things happened. And so the chew stick and the birch sticks were just part of the culture. Today we know, because we can measure the bacteria in people's mouths, when you start using xylitol regularly, gradually you will reduce the plaque bacteria, the harmful strep mutans in your mouth, and develop healthy bacteria. We know that xylitol is a prebiotic. It actually feeds the good bacteria in your mouth. And the biofilm of the mouth has a lot in common with the biofilm of our skin. Actually more so than the biofilm of our gut. This is why using a probiotic really doesn't work so well on skin and really doesn't work so well in the mouth. We need xylitol used alongside diet, nutrition, periods of what I like to call mouth resting. This is a time when you allow your own saliva to actually heal your teeth and your gums. And one of the cool things about xylitol is that when you eat it, not only is it this prebiotic that feeds the good bacteria, it also helps to get rid of the plaque, but one of the things it does is it stimulates a flow of saliva into your mouth. And if you have dry mouth, that's one of the problems for you for growing good bacteria and having healthy teeth. Xylitol stimulates a flow of saliva from different kind of salivary glands. See, we have salivary glands under our jaw. That's what makes most of the time the saliva in our mouth. When we're eating, the up and down chewing stimulates what we call digestive saliva. It's more watery and more full of enzymes to break down food. When you eat xylitol and you have this mint on the top of your tongue, it actually pulls saliva from the dorsum of your tongue. It's above your tongue. It's in the roof of your mouth, little tiny salivary glands. Also the gland, the tubercular gland that's at the back of your, where your nose and your throat meet. And this saliva is different. It's more full of minerals. It's actually super saturated. It's dripping with the minerals that your teeth need. And it also has a lot of immune cells in it that is very good if you're trying to heal your gums. So this influx of saliva into your mouth is hugely beneficial if you stop eating and drinking afterward. This is why xylitol hasn't always been fully appreciated. If you just sit there eating mint after mint after mint and say, I've eaten 12 mints today, you won't see nearly as much benefit as eating one or two mints and then resting your mouth. Think of it like building your muscle at the gym. If you go to the gym every single day and work out every single day for hours and hours and you never stop, yes, you'll break down your muscles and you'll probably keep breaking them down. But if you work your muscles, break them down, but then rest them, they will rebuild themselves, and they'll rebuild themselves with new muscle cells that are stronger and healthier and younger. And that's the same thing with your teeth. Crystals of enamel break down every time we eat and drink anything. There is an automatic dissolving of the minerals in your mouth. If immediately you have xylitol and bring these minerals in your saliva, the ones your teeth crave and need, right into your mouth immediately afterwards, you rebuild those damaged enamel crystals, the minerals are replenished, and your teeth will stay young, strong, healthy, a good color. They won't be uber white. They won't be some artificial color white. They'll be as white as nature intended your teeth to be. So from thousands of years ago to the numerous studies that have been done all the way through the last 50 years showing the benefits of xylitol, there are still more wonderful studies about to be published on the power of xylitol.